Okay. Wasn't that Al Jarreau? I don't remember. Miles, can you help me with this? Al Jarreau? No.
I will just look that up on my phone as you guys are talking.
No, don't even touch your phone at this point, please.
Oh, shit. Oh,
oh my gosh.
Bob Withers. Or Bill Withers. Bill Withers.
So, I don't really play a little sounds like an intro thing, but we'll forgo that tonight and just keep it simple and just get started. How's that? All right. Give us a thumbs up out there in the crowd if we're good to go. Oh, there you go. Oh, hearts and thumbs up. Oh my gosh. This feedback is just amazing, Miles. Here we go. Hey, everybody. Welcome to Static Show. This is Bob.
Hey, everyone. Miles.
That's scared Miles because he's on the virtual stage here. Aren't you gonna? Oh, somebody's playing in the background. Is that Al Jarreau?
Okay, do a copyright. I can't play.
Yeah, don't play any more than that. All right.
Yeah, I don't. Yeah, I don't want to get sued. Yeah. Okay.
So we are on Plausible right now. And we have our audience of two, I think, right now, which is fantastic for this first show in this format. So we have I don't want to scare you, Miles, but we have the CEO of Plausible with us tonight. I don't know if you knew that, but
I don't know. Okay.
Also known as the girl from Waukegan. I think that's her new Twitter handle, girl from Waukegan.
Yeah.
I'm pushing for that. I'm really trying to make that stick, but I don't know if it's going to happen or not, but we'll see. Yeah, we got a yeah. So Plausible is a platform for comedians to do their stand-up in a virtual format, just so everybody knows. And I actually talked to Leanne last week, and it was a very interesting conversation, and I said, hey, we ought to try that. You know, Miles and I do this whole kind of free-form, you know, kind of hippie thing, and I thought we could do that here. So we're going to tell a few stories. Hopefully you'll have a few giggles, and it'll take us here about, I don't know, 25 minutes, 30 minutes, something like that. That's usually the show, right, Miles?
Sometimes.
you're such a weirdo. I swear to God, you probably, have moths in your house with spindles of yarn and thread or something.
I still have that camera in that bathroom where I had you shower.
Yeah, I know. Your hidden camera in the plastic box in your basement.
I'm hoping you come back someday. I want to put a part two to that.
Yeah, look how much fatter he is. We have this tape from 10 years ago. God.
Try the loofah. Try the loofah.
He barely fits into this coffin of a shower that I have here in the basement made out of plastic melamine or whatever it was. Oh my God. So anyway, I have a story. I wasn't sure what I was going to talk about tonight. As always, we just kind of wing everything. And so I was like, you know, what's the world going to hand me to talk about on this kind of inaugural thing with Plausible and so forth? And boy, did it hand me a doozy. So, people who listen to the show may remember this or, you know, may not be aware. Who knows? Who cares? But, my wife's father was a dentist. And so I had pretty much a dentist that I would go see for a very, very long time, right? So once I met my wife and things got serious, he became my dentist, right? So I've always had this kind of in, which has always kind of irked Miles to no end, that I kind of had free dental coverage through being
drilled by your father-in-law.
Yeah, well, yeah, I know you love to sell that joke. So he passed away a couple of years ago, which is very sad. God rest his soul.
It is sad.
I had to get a new dentist. And so I've talked about him a couple of times, actually at Christmas time. I have a dentist. He's Polish. I can't even remember his last name. It's so long. And, he's of Polish descent.
As I am, as me.
Like yourself, exactly.
I'm one quarter, so
just, yeah, yeah. Just we saying. Don't know what quarter that is, but so I have this Polish dentist, and I've been going to see him, and he's a nice guy, and he knew when we first went there, you know, he gave us a discount because my father-in-law was a dentist. He's a very nice guy. So we've been going there for a while, and I've had this kind of issue that he's been dealing with, and it always ends up, so he's the only one that can do it. He owns like a practice, right? So he's got multiple dentists working for him, but he's the only one that works on me, but he only works like a couple days a week because he's a rich dentist. So so I've been having this ongoing dental work going on. And then today I was supposed to go in, and there was this big ice storm. If you live in the Midwest, there was a big kind of ice storm. And actually, if you watch, and I was just talking to Miles about this, if you watch on the news, there's this video that's floating around of a fire truck who does a donut on a residential street. And that was not too far from where I live, right? And so it's on the national news everywhere. It's this big fire truck doing a donut in the middle of a suburban area. And so this morning I wake up, I was supposed to go to my appointment at 8:00. I wake up early and I'm like, you know, I call in, I'm like, hey, this weather's so terrible. I don't think I'm going to make it. You know, nobody's at the office or anything. And probably about 10 minutes later, I get a text, and it's my dentist. He's texting me, which is weird. And he goes, hey, we're closing today. The staff can't make it. And he goes, do you want to reschedule? And I'm like, yeah. I go, roads are terrible. I said, how can I reschedule for next Monday if you have that? He's like, I'm going to read you this text verbatim. And you're going to love this, Miles. Let's do February 5th. Next Monday, I have a doctor's yearly physical and unfortunately my first colonoscopy.
Oh, wow. Holy cow. Holy cow.
And then I see this morning at like 8:00 when I'm supposed to be there. I'm like, how do you respond?
Happy endings? I don't know.
How do you respond to your dentist sending you? A text like that. I just said, okay, thanks. I'm like, I mean, other than this little interaction with, he never knew my father-in-law, right? I don't know him other than we went in and he became my dentist. Like, I filled out paperwork like everybody else, right? I mean, it's not like I go play poker with the guy.
Right.
And here he is telling me he's getting his first colonoscopy. I thought that was a little personal. What do you think?
Well, it's better than a prostate exam, I guess, right?
Is it?
I've had both. I don't know.
Is it? Is it really? Do you really?
I don't know. I've had both. I don't know.
Well, I know you love to talk about it. That's why I figured you'd really enjoy that story. And I was kind of like,
about men's issues. So what? Yeah, so what?
Oh, my God.
You should get yours checked, by the way. I'm just
saying. I know. You always keep telling me that. And I'm like, Now I'm really put off the whole thing because, I mean, now all I do is I picture my dentist getting it up the butt with a scope. I mean, oh, now when I got to go see him in 2 weeks, he's going to have his hands in my mouth, and all I'm going to see is him on a table laying sideways.
Oh, God.
With the Roto-Rooter going on.
Yeah.
I mean, it's bad enough that every time I talk to you, I think about that because you love to talk about your exams.
I've had one where they knock you out, and I have one where they actually do not knock you out.
Oh, really? I should have asked him. I should have wrote back and I said, hey, are you going to get knocked out or are you going to be awake for this one?
I got to watch it on TV.
What?
I told you that. They put a TV in.
You were looking up your own butt.
I know. I was. I'm like, okay. It's like you're on the outside. You're like, oh, okay. Hey, I've been working out. Next thing you know, I was like,
I've been working out.
Hey, Mo.
Yeah, I know. It's funny enough you just said I've been working out. That's not normal for you. Well, you like one Oreo at a time or what?
Well, back in the day, I'm just saying.
Oh, okay. You know. Yeah, well. But anyway, I just thought it was very peculiar that my dentist would send me.
That's a little weird.
I was like, should I get him a card? Like, is there a first colonoscopy card or something that you can send somebody? You know, I mean, you know.
A little specific. I don't know.
You know, I have a daughter, and so, you know, things happen to young ladies, and you kind of celebrate them. Is this kind of a celebration thing like that, or should I just ignore it? Or
instead of Sierra, like mark out Ken Sierra on the card, I guess, and put colonoscopy.
No, yeah, Ken Sierra. Well, I have to look up how to spell colonoscopy in Spanish. What would that be?
Oh, man, that's... You know, the Spanish I know really... Yeah,
yeah, you're the guy. Yeah. You got, 1 year of high school Spanish on me, so...
I have... Well, I've actually been to Mexico 3 times.
So. Oh, that's true.
Don't want to brag.
Any of those times did you ever get a colonoscopy?
How many times?
Any of them. Whenever you were down there those 3 times, did you get a colonoscopy?
Oh, that no. No. Oh. No, I did not get that done there. I don't know. I didn't have anything weird done there, no.
Oh, okay. Finger?
Although there was a lady in a cab that was offering her services for 2 hours straight, and I thought, 2 hours?
2 hours.
2 hours?
You're like, do you do fractions?
We're going to be, like, watching a lot of TV, I think, or something. I don't know. Like, 2 hours? Like,
yeah.
Like, I'm a
forgo the maid, let you clean my room.
Yeah. Holy cow, 2 hours.
Oh, my gosh. So what's going on with you, Miles? I got to figure this out now.
I want to say just a couple things before I start, if I could, about our guest.
Say whatever you want. Holy moly, what are you doing?
It's Leanne, correct? Leanne, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. It's weird because like you're like so dark. It looks like you're like in like the Blair Witch Project. It looks like there's like a hand that's gonna come out of nowhere and grab you by the mouth or something. It's spooky. It's scary.
She's
so dark.
Heather Donahue, right? Heather Donahue was in the
Blair Witch Project. Yeah, I mean, she used bad words a lot. Yeah, I know. I think it would be her, but that was weird.
I think this actually, you can cuss if you want. I don't think that we have to be clean, do we? I think finger up the butt puts us in the explicit category.
I don't like to cuss, you know that.
Oh, come on.
Well, I thought, oh, there we go. Okay, I feel better. Okay, you just kind of freaking me out with that. Okay.
So what's going on, Miles? I'm trying to get you to do your story. You're totally distracted at this point.
This topic is not anything to laugh at, but I really thought I might have like breast cancer or something this morning. I was very freaked out.
Would you like to reveal to the audience your cup size?
At this point, maybe A.
Oh, no, you're definitely more than an A. I can tell you that right now. Jaws? Do you remember the movie Jaws, everybody?
Yeah.
There was this old guy that comes walking out of the ocean towards one of the beach scenes. Just kind of drooping.
I'm kind of like Burt Crusher, I suppose.
Definitely. I tell you, Burt Crusher totally stole your look. That's for certain.
Yeah. No. That was weird. No, I was like, I was getting ready for work, and I looked in the mirror, and I'm like, my one areoli looked dark, really dark.
Really?
And I thought, oh my God.
Were you fiddling with yourself while you were sleeping?
I don't know. I was like, this is weird. This. Thank you. Thank you. Well, I come out of nowhere. Wow. No, it was weird. And then I go, what is this? Right?
Yeah. Well, let me ask you a question.
Go ahead.
If I may interject. Because I think on at least one of your areoli, you have, you know, like protuberances that are not a nipple.
I have skin tags.
On both of them or on just one of them?
Both.
Oh, okay. Well, I thought I was gonna delineate via that, but apparently not.
No. I tried to send you a picture once.
No, yeah, I know. I don't want to see any more of your...
I was in the hospital. Remember, I thought I was dying. I sent you a bunch of dirty stuff just in case I died. I wanted you to see all this dirty stuff.
Yeah. I do recall it. I think I said, no, please, no.
I sent you a picture of that severed cat's head.
I've been exposed to so many things so far.
Remember that severed cat's head? You're like, don't send me the severed cat's head picture, please.
Right, and you did. You did, yes.
Well, I thought I was dying. I thought, well, just in case I die, I think you should see it.
So well, I don't need it. It's about as I need that about as much as I need to know my dentist is getting the colonoscopy.
Right? I know. Well, who goes to like some weird freak show and they're selling like animal heads in a jar? I
mean, well, that's weird. Apparently. Get back to your nipple. I'd rather hear about your nipple.
I wouldn't know what had I known there was cat's heads in jars. No. Bro.
Tell me more about the nipple.
All right. Well, my areoli. So, no, but it turned out some lint had gathered, I guess, or something.
Darkness. That's disgusting.
And
were you rolling around in bed gathering lint on your... Were you wet?
I don't know. I don't know how that happened. I don't know how it happened.
Were you producing
really dark.
Milk?
No. No, I wasn't. I was not lactating, no. And it's like, it wouldn't come off at first, but I kept rubbing it. And it finally came off. For like a second there, I go, oh my God, what is this? Like some weird...
I think you have a career on 4chan or something. I don't know, someplace else.
And I mean, it's not funny. I know it's not funny because that's a very serious issue and stuff like that. But I go, am I going to have a mess?
Oh, the breast cancer, yeah.
Yeah, no, I was so freaked out. I was like, oh my God.
So what did you keep it or?
I oh, sad. No, it's not sad, everybody. Come on, don't be sad. I did not keep it. I just kind of balled it up and threw it on the floor, I guess. I don't know.
Yeah, let's not dispose of it properly. Let's just throw it on the floor and you know, hope for the best. My wife is going to clean anyway eventually, so.
Eventually, yes. So.
Yeah. Oh my.
I'm pleased to say I'm okay now, but
did you give yourself a thorough exam after that?
No, I did not.
Oh,
I did not.
Okay.
Because I had.
You
to
might
want to
consider it. I mean,
after that, I might.
Yeah,
I might.
I mean, you know, any unwarranted lumps, perhaps. I don't know.
I don't know. I'm more worried about these skin tags right now, I'll tell you the truth. Because they will cut them off. Like, they'll cut off, like, what is it? It's like basically a buck per tag, basically. So.
Where, are you like at a Claire's boutique at the mall or something?
Yeah, no, I know a lady that she'll do it, but she'll do it. But it's
Miles, I think that'll be like a buck a tag here. We can do it this afternoon in the back in the barber chair. You're all good.
Well, they deaden you up. I mean, they shoot you up with something and then they, start snipping, you know.
Oh, my goodness, really?
Yeah. If they've missed some, like they're just cutting it without like no, deadening, you know, it's just like,
How often have you had this done?
I've had this done at least twice. And my doctor tried to do it once and he just kind of quit after a while. He got so grossed out. He's like, I can't, it is so filthy and gross, Miles. I'm not going to do anymore.
He's so skeeved out by your... You're like, how many of these effing things have you got? For Christ's sake, it looks like Stonehenge on this areola.
I know, man. Yeah, it's a time. You can tell time on it, I think.
Yeah, exactly. Stand out, lay down in the sun, and we'll see what it's lunchtime yet? Holy moly.
I think I sent you a picture of it once.
Yes, actually. I've seen it. Unfortunately, I have.
I'll send it to Leanne if she wants to see it, I guess. But
I don't think that's in her wheelhouse either. Come on.
She's from the city. She's seen some stuff.
Probably.
Right? We're both from the burbs, right?
Yeah. Miles is from Chicagoland, yeah.
Aurora. Aurora-ish.
Yeah, Wayne's World.
ish. I say ish.
Yeah, ish. Yeah. He was from a little more hoity-toity area.
No, that's all we need to say about that area. Okay, don't say anything more about it or anything weird that happened there. No.
Can I mention that you went to high school with Andy
Richter? No. You may not mention that. No.
I've mentioned it 100 times.
Yeah, I know.
Oh, okay. I don't know if you heard me. He went to high school with Andy Richter. So. But his name was not Andy Richter. Dun, dun, dun.
He told me to shut up once, which I have never forgiven him for. So there can be no peace in my mind until the apology.
From Andy Richter.
That's what I'm waiting.
He sounded so ominous. That was just terrible. Well, so your boob going to be okay?
I think so.
I was a little worried. I mean, although to be honest with you, if you had to get, something cut off, there's worse things that could happen to you.
That's true.
A guy getting, cancer taken out of his breast is probably pretty low on the don't want it to happen. It's happened.
No, it can happen.
No, I know. I don't know. I know.
It can happen. No. Yeah, it can happen.
I would think, testicular would probably be a little more frightening for you.
I'd put that in my top three ways that I will probably go, yes.
Testicular cancer?
I'm 100% certain of it.
Oh, wow.
Sorry.
If that's in the, what's the other two in the top three?
The way Michael Hutchins went, I think, would be
autoerotic
awesome.
Asphyxiation.
Yes, I would. I think, not that I support that kind of thing, but I'm just saying.
That's what you need. That's what you need.
I think, yeah, I just thought that'd make like an awkward like Thanksgiving conversation. Like, did you hear about Uncle Miles?
Miles.
Yeah.
Yeah, he was, rubbing his nipple in the closet with rope around his neck.
Da-da-da-da-da-da.
And what's the other one then?
I haven't decided yet.
It's a fill in the blank. I got my top three here. Testicular cancer, autoerotic asphyxiation, and other.
Take me over.
Oh my God.
Matter of fact, if I looked, I actually have a vial full of dried skin tags that the doctor took.
Yes, I know. I've seen the picture of that as well.
They're dried out. You can actually rattle it like a baby rattle, actually.
Well, whenever you sent it to me, they weren't dry yet. They were still looked like some kind of insect or slug or something, like tiny slugs.
That's not the worst thing I ever sent to you. So.
Yes, I know.
Yeah. I've sent you inappropriate.
Yeah, there's been way more inappropriate things that you've sent to me. And usually through the U.S. mail.
Well, not anymore. I think that, I think.
Yeah, thankfully that stopped because my mailman was not amused.
And that's all we're going to say about that. That's all we're going to say about that.
Well, Miles, anything else on your breast before we go?
No, I'm, got it all off my chest, I guess.
As it were,
As it were, yeah.
Is boob lint really a thing? That's what that may be something to look up.
Well, if I can find some more, I'll take
maybe
a picture.
Maybe you were molting. Maybe it was you were molting.
This has never happened before.
Yeah, I know, but you get older and things happen, things change.
I know. Tell me about it. I know.
Yeah. This wasn't weird on your stuff. Third nipple, was it?
I'm not Scaramunga from Man with the Golden Gun, for Christ's sakes.
You never know. You never know.
I'm not Christopher Lee, for God's sakes.
Well, folks, this has been fun here on Plausible tonight, and thanks for joining us. And Leanne, thank you for being such an incredible host as we have got this going tonight. And Thanks, Brian, for being part of our duo audience. And folks, we'll catch you all next time.